So in today's video we are going to be doing something very different today, and it's a topic which I was debating whether I should cover or not, but I thought this is a football channel, we cover latest news and this is a big development. So I mean, you know, maybe not the best for ASMR and sleeping because it's a very sensitive topic, but we're going to be talking about the Mason Greenwood case, because if you're unaware, there's been some big news that has come out. So I'm going to give my thoughts on it and the case and what should happen next. But of course, as I said, it's a very sensitive topic, so I'm going to try to be, you know, very careful with what I say here. But I'm just going to give my opinion on what's been going on. So if you do not know what's happened, let me run through it. So, charges of attempted rape and assault have been dropped against Manchester United footballer Mason Greenwood. The 21-year-old was arrested in January 2012 amid allegations surrounding images and videos. He was later charged with attempted rape, controlling and coercive behaviour, and assault, occasioning actual bodily harm. In a statement, Greenwood said he was relieved and thanked his family and friends for supporting him. The Crown Prosecution Service said the charges were discontinued after key witnesses withdrew from their involvement. And then, within hours of allegations surfacing at the beginning of 2022, the forward was suspended from playing or training with Manchester United. A Man United representative said the club had noted the decision of the Crown Prosecution Service that all charges against Mason Greenwood have been dropped. The club will now conduct its own process before determining next steps, they said. We will not make any further comment until that process is complete. The BBC understands that Greenwood will not return to training or play until this process is complete. Greater Manchester Police said it was only fair to announce Greenwood would no longer face criminal proceedings. The chief constable added, "I would, however, like to use this opportunity to reiterate the force's commitment to investigating allegations of violence against women and girls, regardless of their circumstances, throughout what can be a hard and upsetting time for them." Right. So Greenwood's charges have been dropped. Now, if you've not seen the video, I think most of you have seen the video. If you haven't, I'm telling you now, do not watch it. You're best not to, because it is very upsetting. And it's awful. But if you have seen it, you know what video I'm referring to. And this is what the case was based on. So I think it's really shocking to a lot of people how this has happened. I think we have to take it in consideration that, you know, the phrase innocent till proven guilty, and everyone has their side of the story. But so I understand that, and you know, he's been proven to be innocent here. But I'm just, the video which we saw, obviously, you know, there's context behind everything, etc. But the context behind that, I don't really see it. So I'm really baffled by this decision. But what it's telling to me is this part: the Crown Prosecution Service said the charges were discontinued after key witnesses withdrew their involvement. So the only reason the charges have been dropped is because key witnesses withdrew. So that doesn't necessarily say that he's innocent, it just means the witnesses no longer wanted to go through with the case. Now, for what reason, we have no clue, and we probably never will know whether that's been paid off, whether that's
It's a very sensitive topic. But yeah, I think
I said,